Guten Tag, ich möchte Sie gerne bekannt machen mit unserer amerikanischen Künstlerin Grimanesa Amorós, die eigens aus New York gekommen ist, um hier im Ludwig Museum die große Lichtinstallation OCUPANTE vorzustellen, die wir im Erdgeschoss zeigen und sowohl auch ihren Film, der ebenfalls OCUPANTE trägt als Titel. Wir werden kurz über die Ausstellung reden, gemeinsam, damit Sie ein paar Impressionen von Grimanesa Amorós bekommen. So, I just introduced you. So, what was your first idea of bringing this kind of exhibition and this concept to this place?
Well, my first thought was that I truly wanted to have become very, very familiar with the Ludwig Museum in Koblenz. What that means to me is that to know the museum from in to outside. So I studied very, very well the what I call the first floor, the second floor, the how do you get in, and then how, if you keep on walking further, you will discover the German corner where the muscle and the brain gets together. So for me that was very important. So how do I get familiar with the building and with the structure and with the rooms? So this way I could truly be creative and make the best conceptual exhibition for the space, for the site specific, which is what basically, what I always, my intention is for the viewer, myself, and the architecture to become one in that moment, every time they see a piece. So that's, if I honor the architecture of the space, then the space is going to receive very well the installation. That's what I feel. So that was very important for me.
Yeah. Also, you show with your light installation the idea of the two rivers coming together. So, actually, you are bringing the outside nature into our museum, and also transferring the nature into a light sequence. Mm-hmm. So people can experience many, many things, and at the same time, they can experience the space, the transformation of space, the transformation of nature, having feelings or ideas about the light, yes, especially the light. And it's also a kind of musical composition. So it's the sequence of light you were putting, referring to the river rhythm, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. I think you have explained it very well. And to me, sometimes there's nothing more perfect than nature itself. Nature is really an important ingredient into my work, and since sometimes I think it's very interesting the relationship from the outside to the inside and vice versa, and I feel that I have achieved the communication that was my intention when I was thinking what I was going to be doing at the Ludwig Museum in Koblenz.
Yeah, and I have to say that this is, for us, of course, the first time that we ever have an artist who is really actually working with light, mm-hmm, within our building. And it's where you're one of the big names, like international-wise, you are working also close, not with, but close, like James Turrell with light, and for Olafsson as well, like with light, but they are all different kinds of expectations towards light. What I like best in your light sequences is really the sequence of light, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, that we are not only overwhelmed by light, for example, like James Turrell likes to do, but that we also can see the technical part of it. Mm-hmm. Which is amazing to follow up.
Well, I feel that you mentioned some of the big names in life, and I feel that it's our responsibility as artists in general to truly be informed about, in my case, what other artists that they work with light are doing, right? So you have to learn what artists are using with fiber, optics. Some of them are using neon, and some of them are the ones, you know, LEDs. LEDs is always, I like to say, it's a bit more complex because there's a lot of electrical hardware involved for them to be able to work. And it's, I feel that it's very important to be informed, because then you might be able to think that you were, you know, very creative with an idea, but then you turn around and you see perhaps something very similar. So I always urge, when I have some lectures in universities or in other platforms, about how important it is to truly look around, to read, and to sometimes, nowadays we have no excuses with the internet. Things are much more available for us. We just put a link and all the information come to us. So that's what I think it's very important.
Yeah, it's a great experience, maybe for you as well, to go to different places and really to explore the space and the surrounding, but for us as a museum as well. So we appreciate very much being here with you together, and we hope that, of course, the exhibition is a huge success.
Yes, I think that normally people, when they come, they perceive the authenticism about truly the love and the relationship that I have with the conceptual idea that I come to do an exhibition, but at the same time taking truly very seriously in consideration the architecture space, in this case of the Ludwig Museum, you know, in Koblenz. And I'm glad to say that through the time I have been here, through the opening, through the guided visits, I have been able to appreciate how people truly, really communicate with the work. And that to me is, of course, you know, wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I think so.